dancing all alone. No one hit your phone up, your internet is slow. There's a place you can go and you can call home. When you're kinda blue and outside it's raining, Spotify your favorite dudes. There's a place you can go and you can call home. One big family, not just you and me. Barong family loves ya, best gang in the world. From China to The Hague, from Bali to LA, family matters.
We are indeed the best gang in the world.
And family still matters.
That's true.
Back at again.
Number two.
Back at it again.
We're here. Barong Family Radio Show number two.
I'm super hyped.
Me too. I'm pumped for this one.
I'm super pumped.
Super pumped.
I am super pumped.
I'm pipe pumped.
I am motherfucking ultra pumped.
I'm psyched.
I'm not even a little pumped. I'm big pumped.
God damn it. Okay, what are we talking about this week? Do we got music? Are we talking about like investments? Are we talking about relationships? What are we doing this week? Jim, tell me now. What are we doing?
It's a combination. We're investing in musical relationships. It's actually a whole themed episode about the new Barong Family album.
We've done this before.
We've done
a Barong Family album before. It is a while back.
It is a while back.
And we did a second one. We traveled to China.
China, Shanghai.
We went to Shanghai. Brought all the family members. We rented two houses. One to sleep and fuck. One to make music. One to make music. Sleep and eat, of course.
Sleep and eat.
And then no raving.
No raving.
No raving. Just taking the subway to the other loft and making music. And
because maybe by now you saw the documentary, and the funny thing is, we rented this super cool loft.
Yeah.
But after we rented it, we found out that like the guy that was running it out, like the Airbnb, the Chinese Airbnb, he was a complete Nazi. He wouldn't let us like play loud music. He would like, we couldn't even have sick sleeping there because he was snoring so loud. So we had to rent another house that wasn't bawling at all. And the guys were so happy that they actually had a like somebody running it that we could make music there loud.
Yeah.
So we did. So we went to China.
We went to Shanghai. We went there for 5 days, somewhat of a week. And
some guys stayed for like 4 days. Some stayed for like 6 days. Like everybody, it was like coming in and out. Like it's like a whorehouse. Like a whorehouse.
Exactly like a whorehouse.
Dudes
actually
walking in and out, musical, making noise.
Musical whorehouse. And the recipe was still the same. Everybody must collab with somebody.
Yeah. Like a whorehouse.
Like a whorehouse.
You gotta collab.
You don't have one without the other.
Nothing. There's no.
No magic. Nothing happens.
Nothing.
No.
And everybody is actually trying to make a hit, whoring it up.
Honestly, we didn't try. We made so much music.
Yeah.
It was like, we made so much music. We had to separate it over two albums, actually.
Yeah, because when we did the first listening session, we were like, okay, the guys made like 30 demos, probably 20 are gonna suck. And then in the end, like maybe 5 or 6 sucked, like mostly sick stuff. And a couple of Mike Savello's songs really sucked too.
Yeah, yeah.
He's gonna get a separate email about that.
Mm-hmm.
And then we just really had to say like, we can't drop all of these at the same time. We're gonna make it a part one and part two. So it's actually two albums.
So next year we're just chilling, one big fucking holiday. I'm doing nothing
next year. You'll be calling us like, yo, what's up with the new, fuck you bitch, we gave you two albums last year.
Shut up.
Double pump.
Exactly.
Did
we forget anything, or we're just gonna play some new music?
Maybe play a couple of those songs.
Yeah, why not.
shake it out, pop it good, bounce it, bounce it, bounce it. Baby, goonies, goonies, runners, goonies, 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 runners. Goonies, goonies, runners, goonies, goonies, goonies. Okay, just shake it out, pop it good, bounce it, shake just like you should. Shake it out, pop it good, bounce it, bounce it. Okay, just shake it, shake it, shake it, shake it, shake it. Pop it, pop it, pop it, pop it, pop it good. Bounce that shit just like you should. Bounce that shit just like you should. Shake it, shake it, shake it, shake it, shake it.
Personal favorites.
Everything was good.
And for instance, I'm a DJ.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to play all of them.
Yeah, oh, definitely.
What did we play? We played one song by Sick and Azar.
Yeah.
I think they still have to.
The trappy stuff. It's loud as fuck.
Big fucking drop.
Yeah, it's dope.
Then we played Sesco Looney Tunes.
Mm-hmm.
Personally, this is a collab I've been waiting on for years.
Yeah.
These three songs are amazing, but like we said, like all the songs are pretty amazing, and that's the coolest part about this whole project, and this was the second time we did it, is like just getting people in the studio that would never collaborate, or like, you know how that goes, like artists, every artist has this kind of like pride thing, like you just don't step up to another artist going like, yo, like being all fanboyish, like, yo guy, Want to collab?
Definitely.
Collab,
and
bro.
And everybody has a lot to do, and everybody's busy.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And like, but the funny thing is, like, there are like collabs on this album, which happened before.
Yeah.
But were such a great success that they wanted to make another song, and one of those is the Mike Cefalo Galaxy song called Luxor 2.
Luxor 2.
2 Dutch.
Luxor.
2. Luxor. Luxor 2.
Luxor.
With a great vocal this time, and a great take on the previous drop.
Really feels like a part two, but with respect to
yeah,
the first part.
Definitely. Like how the Godfather 2.
Godfather 2 is a very good example.
Yeah.
I would say like a bad example would be probably The Hangover 2.
Definitely.
Not funny.
Bad Moms 2.
Definitely. But the Moxie Rewreck, I remember the first time we did the studio week, they did the master song, one of my favorites of the.
How did that go again?
Thijs, can you play a little bit of master just to refresh the people's memories? One of my favorites we did. I even remember them sitting upstairs in the French cottage. They had like the pool table.
Oh yeah.
That they put on the.
That was the best room, actually.
It was the best room.
Was it a pool table? Oh yeah, they were producing on the pool table, and the ping pong table was free to use.
Yeah, yeah.
That was it. That was actually the.
Is this one? Yeah, just go to the drop. Woo!
this was dope.
Yeah. Thank you, Thijs.
Yeah. And let me see, what else is there? If we could like give an award to like the artist who produced like the best and the most stuff for this album, who would it be? I have a good idea. I think there's one guy who influenced everybody and who made the most really good songs.
I'm wondering if you're talking about the same thing.
I think it's Manessa.
Manessa definitely could be it. This guy really, really showed himself and
for
really
a first timer. For a first timer.
You could feel like he came in as like a. First of all, he's from the Caribbean.
Yeah, he's from Curacao, which is next to Aruba. For the Americans
Dutch
who are listening right now,
with a very funny accent.
Yeah,
like if you're Dutch and he starts speaking, like you really gotta like not laugh.
Yeah,
because it's just funny, which gives him like a setback in the studio.
Yeah,
no. He has his own fashion style. Which is probably very...
I just call it style.
It's very Caribbean too. He walks around in Holland like with these like short like Hawaiian jeans,
yeah,
I guess.
Yeah, and the shirts and like everything.
So he really came in like trying to prove himself. But also I was really surprised about Azar.
Definitely.
Also like a new guy.
Maybe it's actually a tie. Now you mention Azar, it actually...
Yeah, because I was thinking about Azar at first, but also a little bit about Manessa.
Yeah.
But maybe it's also because their sound for us is the freshest and the newest, so we are most surprised with him.
Maybe we're a little bit biased.
Yeah. Did they actually work on a song together?
Azar
and Manessa. They didn't, right? Ah, man. Missed opportunity.
No, they didn't. No.
Next time. But also really, really surprised by a kid named Tsunamo.
Yep.
Who we've been friends with for a long time, but I never really knew his true potential in the studio.
No. And I didn't know he could actually sing.
No, it's crazy. Started singing, started producing.
Writing songs.
Started making noodles, like multi fucking talented.
Yeah, it's crazy.
Dope.
Yeah.
And then there's guys like Sesco, Mike. They are just like almost like veterans at this stuff. You can just put them in the studio and they'll
Yellow
just
Claw.
Definitely Yellow Claw. They'll
straight
just
veterans.
Drop bangers after bangers. Good to have Vivek in there with his specific sound.
Yeah.
I was also very surprised by the Moxie and Manessa collab too. Like that's one of those things you're like, you can't foresee that coming. You know,
no.
Like what? How would that sound like? One guy that's more like into these like Moombahton vibes. These two guys that are more into these UK kind of vibes and.
But the whole week was a lot of fun, and it was so good to catch up with everybody. And there was a lot of good dinners we did with everybody, and like we had some really good traditional Chinese food, and it was just a fun week.
Cold as fuck, though.
Whoa, really cold.
Yeah.
And I came from 4 weeks chilling on like this island in Thailand. Whoa, it was a rough start. I like the first couple of days, I just wore all my clothes.
I saw that.
Yeah, it was crazy.
I didn't know.
There's one shot in the documentary where you see me wearing like a purple sweater, silver body warmer, and like this rosé pants with like... And
white pants too.
And a gray Louis Vuitton bag. Like, it's crazy.
I was like, is he changing up his style? Is he just like, did he just come back from a holiday and didn't bring any clothes for winter?
It's a little bit of both.
Yeah, because it was kind of a odd style. Like I was like, okay, maybe it's kind of a circus kind of influenced.
Sometimes I just go, you know, as an influencer, sometimes you just go too far.
Definitely.
Yeah, but
definitely.
A fun week.
Good week.
What else can we talk about?
What else should we talk about?
Is it already time for the BARONG Family Classic?
Yeah, Thijs is saying it is.
Yeah, okay, no, let's fucking do it. Yellow Claw and Mighty Fools. Like that.
Yeah.
The very first BARONG Family release ever.
It doesn't get more classic than this.
No.
Like, more classic than this, and you're talking like Mozart.
kiss, kiss, lick, lick, eat that pussy just right. Kiss, kiss, lick, lick, eat that pussy, bitch. I see you kiss, kiss, lick, lick, eat that pussy just right. Kiss, kiss, lick, lick, eat that pussy, bitch.
Lick, 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 pussy, lick, lick, eat that pussy, bitch. I see, lick, lick, eat that pussy, bitch. I see, lick, lick, pussy, lick, lick, eat that pussy, bitch. I see, lick, lick.
Sad news about Mighty Fools, actually.
Sad news about Mighty Fools. They're dropping a new EP. I'll just fuck it.
No, they're actually playing their last set ever on the Barong Family stage in Tomorrowland. They're gonna call it quits after what I believe was a successful run. Yeah. I never saw it, but they they told us it was a very successful 10 years.
Fucked up.
No, we fucking love those guys.
We fucking love those guys.
We've been friends for ages.
And they've been
good producers.
I think they've been touring for like 10 years.
They're done.
Yeah.
They're gonna focus on making music and doing other stuff. So they're definitely not gone, but they're not gonna do DJ shows anymore.
I remember
anymore.
like living in Amsterdam and they were really on that. You know what? I thought their first like big cloudy movement was actually the whole like
the whole fidget house thing.
Yeah,
yeah, definitely.
Like,
they came up
Crookers,
with
that kind of stuff, and they were like playing that stuff and like DJing everywhere. They going big. They were going to the States. They're going everywhere.
Yeah.
I remember the first time we were going to the States. We ever went to the States. We went to Miami. We had two shows. One show didn't have turntables.
True.
This was only like laptop, and the other show was a Matt Decent show somewhere off everything, basically.
Yeah.
In the middle of what now is
back
like
then it felt like that, but actually it was Wynwood.
Yeah, but back then Wynwood wasn't even like
no, it wasn't really really popping.
It was like just a hood.
Yeah.
And
it was 20% art, 80% drugs.
Maybe even
1090.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. But I remember we went to Miami. We went there. The first show was a complete disaster. We came up there, no turntables. We're like, all right, how does everybody play? Yeah, just laptops. We're like, what? We are actual DJs. But a little bit airy said, like, what? We are actual DJs.
Something like that. Quite accurate, actually.
And then we went to the Madison thing the day after. Super excited. We got there. Nobody. Like, there was like 50 people sitting around in the grass, all waiting for Diplo to
come. Smoking grass.
Diplo never showed up. Nobody from Mad Decent showed up. And believe me, I got a lot of love for Mad Decent, but that was one shameless enterprise they had going on there. Only good thing from that night was two things. First, we met Snake there, because it was us, Snake, GTA.
He just released the Bird Machine back then.
And we were like, really into that song.
Yeah, it was a good song.
We were playing it like 110 BPM, pitching it up like crazy because we thought it was a Moonbatong song. But that set aside, we met him, talked to him, like, we're like, what the fuck is this? He's like, I do not know, it is a shit thing. Nobody from Mad Decent is here. After that, Mighty Fools took us to Five Guys.
That's right.
Because this was the first time we were in the States. We had no idea.
Memorable moment.
And they said, yeah, we played in Miami often. You know, if you're in Miami, like, you want a best burger, you gotta go to Five Guys. We're like, five what? Five Guys.
My first response was like, no, thank you. Give me just five girls.
Yeah, definitely.
But then we ate there. It was really good. It was fun.
And it was fun. And they were like telling us about like, whatever.
Yeah.
Had to do this international kind of thing.
Yeah.
And yeah, we did a lot of shows together after.
Good guys.
I remember a good show in Minneapolis.
Philly.
Philadelphia. So sad to hear them stop the Mighty Fools thing.
Yeah.
But also good to hear them focusing on their personal life and their next chapter.
Definitely. And making decisions is winning already. Is it time for some music?
Yeah, they're the...
And a sip of water.
A sip of water and maybe...
No, let's play some new music.
New music?
Definitely. Let's play something off that brand new Ditter EP.
When is it releasing? August 10, right?
Is it already out? Is it coming up? It's coming up. So this is a guy called Ditter,
mm-hmm.
and he made really loud, yeah. hardcore hardstyle stuff for a very long time, and now this is his very first EP, experimenting with a lot of new stuff and a lot of new sounds.
Yeah. He's a nice guy. His actual name is Martin. I met him a few times because he's like one of, I think, Mike Savello's old friends. They're from the same city, Groningen.
Mm-hmm.
And he brought him along a couple of times, like, oh, he's like a quiet, timid sort of guy.
Irritating.
A little bit.
Yeah.
And then he was like, yeah, I'll send you some stuff. And he sent him stuff. It's like the loudest fucking music you ever heard. I was like, what is this?
It's insane. It's so loud.
And so I looked up his account earlier today at Party Flock, which is, I think, is a Dutch site. And it says genres. It says breakcore, darkcore, drum and bass, Frenchcore, industrial hardcore, UK hardcore.
I'm hearing a lot of styles we never made, but let's
also his email address.
Let's explore darkcore.
Darkcore.
Let's explore that. Let's
musically, right?
Yeah, let's explore that on the next Yellow Claw album.
Let's do that. But after that, I googled him,
mm-hmm.
and I came on a Wikipedia. Page,
mm-hmm. yeah,
basically,
yeah. Yeah.
And
we know that website.
Do
yeah.
you use it?
Yeah.
Do you financially support it? But this is quite funny because I think he looked somehow. He found this and got his name raised because Wikipedia Ditter says it's Ditter.
Mm-hmm.
Ditter is an intentionally applied form of noise used to randomize quantization error, preventing large-scale patterns such as color branding in images. I've never met anybody whose name and
is
music
so well thought out
and it matches.
Yeah,
exactly.
Definitely.
This is how his music sounds. Yeah. And maybe that's a good
introduction.
Is it?
Yeah, let's play it.
It's like your 1 euro.
We'll be right back.
this record is a smash. The correct title is actually Lethal Drop. Great title.
Great title again.
Again.
Matching the actual drop.
Definitely. Smart dude, this guy. What are we gonna do right now? Is this the end of the radio show? Can we play some more music? What are we doing? We're looking at Thijs. Do we got any more minutes left? Can we do one more?
It's supposed to be the end, but maybe we can squeeze one more song.
Let's do one more. One more.
And if we do another song, can we, like, not hating on it or whatsoever?
Just a little bit.
A little bit, obviously. Maybe play something chill, something laid back, something a little bit warming for my ears.
Definitely. Like, if I can make a suggestion,
new album,
definitely.
Too.
Let's play Moonlight. It's with a very pretty and talented girl on it. Her name is Lexi. We made the song with Dolph. And
Lexi's from China.
Lexi's from China. And it's just, I like the song.
I think she's from Beijing, if I'm...
Yes, she is, actually.
Yeah?
Yeah, I remember.
Very cute. Very cool attitude, like kind of rapping too. I heard a couple of her songs where she's
fashionably
like,
forward too.
Very fashionably forward. Where she's kind of like rapping and singing.
Yeah. Talented girl. And after this, talented dude called Juyen Sebulba. He's doing the guest mix, right?
Yeah. Not fashionably forward.
Not fashionably forward. No.
But nice guy.
No. Yeah. No, definitely.
Nice guy.
Really great character.
Great character.
Yeah.
Crazy producer.
Crazy producer.
Sometimes maybe too crazy, but very crazy. Like, sometimes he sends over stuff, you just go like, what the fuck?
And he's doing the guest mix this week. 30 Minutes of Madness, Juyen Sebulba. But first, Moonlight, Yellow Claw and Dolph, featuring Lexi.
Yeah, and Juyen is going to blow up. Mark my words.
Wish I could have felt your heart, feel the way you breathe at night. Especially when you're down, just feel like crying. Wish I could have been there now, stand behind you through your fight. But we were never close enough for that. So I watched from miles away, like a hawk I guard my prey. Cause I never
guys, it's Juyen Sebulba, and you're listening to my guest mix for Barong Family Radio.
Powerhouse.
hundreds. Throw that ass back, let me put it on it. But do you want it? Do you really, really?
Okay, just take it now. Pop it good, bounce that shit just like you should. Shake it down, pop it good, bounce that shit just like you should. Take it down, pop it good, bounce that shit just like you should. Shake it down, pop it good, bounce that, bounce that, bounce that. Baby, tune it, stick these runners. Tune it, tune it, stick these runners. Tune it, stick these runners. Tune it, tune it, stick these. Okay, just take it down. Pop it good, bounce that shit just like you should. Shake it down, pop it good, bounce that, bounce that. Okay, just shake it. Shake it, shake it, shake it, shake it. Pop it, pop it, pop it, pop it, pop it good. Bounce that shit just like you should. Bounce that shit just like you should. Shake it, shake it, shake it, shake it, shake it.
I'm gonna
It's Juyen Sebulba, and you're listening to my guest mix for BARONG Family Radio.
Girl, like your ass on fire.